Hello everyone, and welcome to Sine of Our Time. My name is Bruce, and I want to put the factor theorem to good use. If you're just starting to learn about the factor theorem, then I recommend that you watch the first video in the series by clicking on the link above. But if you're comfortable with the theory, then let's use it. Suppose we are given a polynomial and asked to test which of the following binomials are factors of that polynomial. According to the factor theorem, we can conclude that x minus b is a factor of polynomial p of x if and only if p of b is equal to 0. In other words, we find the value of x that makes the binomial equal to 0, and we just hope that when we substitute it into the polynomial that it is also equal to 0. The value of x that makes the first binomial equal to 0 is negative 1. So we substitute negative 1 in place of x in the polynomial. When we simplify, we get 0, which tells us that x plus 1 is a factor of the polynomial. The value of x that makes the second binomial equal to 0 is positive 1. So we substitute positive 1 in place of x in the polynomial. When we simplify, we get positive 2, which tells us that x minus 1 is not a factor of the polynomial. Continuing with this process, let's test the third binomial by substituting negative 2 into the polynomial and simplifying. As we can see, we get a value of negative 28, which is not equal to 0, so we can conclude that x plus 2 is not a factor of the polynomial. And then, let's test the fourth binomial by substituting positive 2 into the polynomial and simplifying. As we can see, we get a value of 0, which tells us that x minus 2 is a factor of the polynomial. Oh, yet another test. The value of x that makes this final binomial equal to 0 is 3 over 2. Now, when we substitute 3 over 2 in place of x in the polynomial, we need to be very careful since we are working with fractions. But when we simplify, we get an answer of 0, which tells us that 2x minus 3 is also a factor of this polynomial. In actual fact, we have identified all of the factors of this polynomial. We know this since the degree of the polynomial is 3, and we have identified 3 different factors, each with a degree of 1, which adds up to 3. In other words, we can rewrite this polynomial in its fully factored form. This is useful because the factored form tells us about the roots, as well as the nature of the roots of this polynomial function. In simple English, it tells us about the x-intercepts of this polynomial function. This question was very kind to us because it gave us a list of binomials to test. But what if we are asked to factor a polynomial and not given any binomials to test? More about that in the next video in this series. Okay, here's a question for you to practice your skills where you can let me know what your answer is in the comments below. Please let me know if you liked this video, and if you'd like to consider the idea of supporting me and my work on Patreon, then please check out the link below. Well, that's all from me, and I want to say a very big thank you for watching.